More than 100 dolphins have now stranded themselves along Cape Cod just this month, and that number is growing. Rescuers are doing the best they can to keep up. They have been able to save many of them.
Scientists will be briefing Congress later this week about the issue. As national correspondent Jim Axelrod reports, they're still looking for the answers.
The alarming number of beached dolphins along a 25-mile stretch of Cape Cod continues to baffle scientists for a third straight week. On Monday, three more dolphins were sighted approaching the shore. Two swam away unharmed, but this one got too close to the beach. Rescuers from the International Fund for Animal Welfare jumped in. The animal later died, and along with three more carcasses discovered over the weekend, the number of dolphin strandings now stands at 102, about the same number usually seen over the course of an entire year.
If I asked you right now to tell me why this is happening, what would your answer be?
I don't know.
So we'll pull this one up and then move that one over there.
Marine biologist Misty Niemeyer has been examining the dolphins that did not survive, looking for clues.
One thing it might tell us is if all these animals do look healthy, then we know that they were a healthy group of dolphins, that it was more likely something geographic or weather-related, something like that, not an emergent disease or toxins or anything like that.
Two dozen of those stranded dolphins were saved and safely released back into the ocean with electronic tags. Scientists like Brian Sharp are now tracking their movements.
When we're looking at the blue line, the green line, and the orange line, this is good. This is a good picture,
yes,
as far as you're concerned.
This is exactly what we want to see.
While many of the dolphins have traveled far away from Cape Cod, the already overworked rescue crews are continuing to monitor dozens of dolphins that remain offshore in Cape Cod Bay.
Is this the most intense two-week period of your career?
It's been about the most intense. We've had a few strandings like this in the past before, but this last few weeks has definitely been pretty intense as far as the numbers of animals that have been coming in a short period of time.
Jim Axelrod is with us now. So the question still is, why are they doing this? What's happening?
Well, they're working under a couple of theories. You know, dolphins are social animals. They travel in pods. So if the leader of the pod is, say, following prey in too close to shore or is sick or disoriented, the rest of the dolphins are going to follow him. Maybe it's the geography of Cape Cod. It's kind of a hook. Mm-hmm. So the dolphins could get in and then not be able to get out. Could be the wacky weather. But they really just don't know.
Why is Congress so concerned about this?
Well, I just think they want to take a look and make sure you have, generally speaking, about 100 dolphins beach a year. Mm-hmm. Now you have 100 dolphins beaching in 3 weeks. So if there is something, say, man-made, if there's a toxin, something like that that's mm-hmm. causing this, they want to just sort of be aware of what's going on. Big mystery.
Yeah. So it's great to have you here.
Good to see you, Charlie.
You too.
Thank you.